wish I knew how you do it to me. I do it to you. Nice. Jerry and the Pacemakers did it, but then the Beatles did that one right there. How do you do? I love that song.
Do you do what you do to me?
Yeah. Now it's the Lover Brothers singing. Hey, Keith, you know,
during
this time, we got some things that are trying to keep people occupied, so to speak. I know people are going crazy. They're stir crazy. Kept in the house, can't do what they're supposed to do. You're a teacher. You're teaching remote in some instances. Then you're back in school. Then you're remote. It's back and forth for you, right?
Yeah.
And it's tough for kids to get out there and get some exercise. It really is. However,
it's not that tough. It's just you're lazy. It's just like get off your butt.
Right. And you need the motivation. Do something. You definitely need the motivation. But
the internal drive.
And there's a karate place that's actually martial arts
Great idea. It was in Belmont,
that's right.
Mass. Yeah.
Bushido martial arts. I probably butchered that, but Bobby,
didn't. You did it good.
Yeah, we're here.
How you doing? So I got Bobby and Bob, right?
Yep, Bobby and Bob. We're on the same phone. Yep.
So what do we say Bob and Bobby? How should we do that? Well, Bob 1, Bob 2.
Bob and Bobby will be just fine.
All right. Now, George Foreman's not in the house, right? Because George has 5 sons, and they're all named George, and his daughter's name is Georgette. You guys knew that, right? Hey, you know, you guys, I was talking to you early in the week. We're talking about the martial arts, and you guys have been doing it differently than anybody else out there. However, as far as the remote, doing the Zoom stuff, you've been doing this for a long, long time before COVID even took place. So tell everybody how that took place.
I started teaching some of my students travel, and I had one particular student that would travel to Europe, and so I started teaching him online. I believe back then it was Windows Live Messenger, and then later we started using Facebook Live to do the classes. That worked pretty well. And then recently we've been using Zoom. When this all happened, we switched over to Zoom, found it was a better platform for us. But also I'm affiliated with some schools, the Japan Karate Institute down in South Carolina, the JKI. And they have several schools out there, and some of the instructors have been training from me online for many years. So we basically had a good handle on it already.
Yeah, I guess so.
I said to my son, we better switch to online and just do straight online classes and try to switch everyone over. So that went, at first it was hard and not everyone was convinced to switch over online. But after a while, some people just, you know, they got bored not training. They started doing it and trying it, and they realized how great it really was. That it's pretty close to what we do in person. You know, there's a few things you're missing, but you actually gain some stuff, too, by doing it online.
So. We're speaking with Bob and Bobby Moran. They own Bushido Martial Arts. It's in Belmont, Massachusetts, and they're doing the Zoom thing, but they were way ahead of the game doing it from long ago, before Zoom even existed. Mm. So my brother Keith is actually a martial artist himself. He's a black belt, not a practicing black belt, but he knows the art. Yeah, he's you know, you practice or you don't practice. Keith's not practicing Bob and Bob.
I've been lifting. I've been a lot of lifting, but yeah, no, second degree black belt. I get that years ago. But anyways, I'm interested in your style, your Bushido. What style? What would you categorize that?
Okay, well, we're a mixture of. I started in judo, so when I was 7. But later on, I got into karate. Yeah. I did some savat. I did karate. And also, I did arnis, which is a Filipino stick and knife fighting system. Yeah. And I trained in kempo and kyokushinkai. So also Wing Chun Kung Fu. So we're like a mixed system. My system is called Bushido Zen Kempo Karate System. It's an advanced system of kempo karate that mixes all of the above of what I just talked about.
The way of the fist, right? Way of the fist, kempo.
Yes.
Yeah. That's great. That's a great combo.
And also we mix Shorin Ryu karate. So we're based on old Okinawan karate. Mm. So most of our techniques come from the kata themselves than moves outside of karate.
I was just scanning some pictures you guys had online. I was looking at one guy blocking a punch, and I go, wow, that looks like the old blocking system, the kempo blocking system. And I was just, that's cool that you mix the styles up. I like that. I like that a lot. As far as the footwork and the kicking, You guys stress?
Footwork's pretty advanced. Yeah. We use a lot of what we call Nihonshi footwork.
Okay.
So it's a lot of trapping the legs, trapping the feet, tripping people up.
Yep.
So it's like when someone kicks, we'll do a block and then step on their foot, redirect their leg, redirect a kick, step on their foot, and trip them up. So
yeah.
It's kind of advanced stuff, but it's we teach it in a way that's pretty easy to learn.
So it's all it's hand to hand. You know, you're upright. Do you guys ever tackle the? You know, I know today everyone's talking about ground fighting.
We do a lot of what we call anti-grappling.
Gotcha.
So a lot of on the ground, we use pressure points to get them in the range to where we can strike them. Or we use pressure point techniques for striking or for subduing them.
That's awesome.
So, and we do use some grappling on the ground also. I did train in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu for a little while.
Oh, man.
I also, at one time, I was training MMA fighters.
That's great. So your style is really applicable to if you guys were you know, not just working with kids, but I mean adults and also even police officers that need to probably learn how to restrain people. You guys would be outstanding instructors for that.
Yeah, definitely. For a long time, I had taught primarily adults.
Yeah.
And just over the last couple of years, we started teaching kids more again.
Right, right. That's great.
I was one of the few karate schools that taught primarily adults.
Yeah.
And then I partnered with my son about a year and a half ago.
Yep, about a year and a half ago.
And we decided to partner with him and wanted to get the kids back into it. So we both are teaching the kids now. He primarily teaches most of the kids, but yeah. I teach some kids groups also, too.
How old is your son?
I'm 23.
Young guy. All right, Bob. That's great. How are you working with your dad? You guys are both martial artists, and you just bring a unique take as far as, you know, you get the older sensei, or you guys refer to sensei or master. I'm not sure.
Yeah.
Okay. And you and you get the younger version, old sensei Bob and young sensei Bob. That's fantastic.
Yeah. It's going great.
Kids must love that.
I would say the father son days at the company picnics go well for you guys. That's good. Hey, I know you guys are doing the driveway teaching, the driveway thing, and you're still doing it now, even with these cold months that we're starting to get. Not as bad as last winter, though.
So we actually still are for some students. Most of them we transition to either do private lessons in the dojo or online.
Yeah.
But actually, we had some students that just weren't just comfortable yet. So we made accommodations, and they made accommodations, and they were so excited to still continue martial arts that they, like, set up spaces in their garages and stuff like that where we can actually still train and go to their homes and make sure that they're comfortable and still teaching martial arts and karate. So we were still doing a few of those. But it was mainly in the summer. We had, like, a lot of people training outside and stuff like that.
Those rubberized turf football fields are really good for landing. I know that.
I played rugby, and I can attest.
Yes, definitely.
I got no turf burn whatsoever.
So getting these kids involved, this is the huge thing, folks. We're speaking with Bob and Bobby Moran from Bushido Martial Arts. They're in Belmont. They're trying to keep the kids together and basically inspire them to get out there and work out. We know things are tough, but these guys are tailor-making it to the people that can't do anything right now. So if you were going to give some kind of advice for the people that are in the greater Belmont area, whether it's Waltham, Watertown, Woburn, Lexington, whatever it might be, let's get them to come to you guys so you can help them out. So what would you do? And plus, there's Zoom, so I guess they could be up there in Bug Tussle, Tennessee, or way up there in Agoncourt, Maine.
Yeah, I just, advise everyone to come try out martial arts, try out karate, because the benefits are great. I mean, we've been both doing it our whole life, and just trying out one class, you can really kind of find something that you truly love and can truly benefit from, not just your child, but adults themselves. We've had families train together, and it's been great, and it's been kind of helping them, doing something together in this kind of tough time. And it's helping kids a lot with their energy, getting their energy out and getting a lot of physical activity. And not only that, but just there's great benefits for your kids. It helps them with their focus, concentration, their confidence, and we teach them really good morals, values, and respect. So it really goes a long way for kids and adults just kind of growing and helping them build character.
That's the way it should be. Guys, could you give out your website and all your contact information for anybody that's interested in taking some martial art training from Bushido down there in Belmont? Go ahead.
Yeah, if you want to try it out, just give me a call at 617-932-9004. You can even shoot me over a text, or you can check out our website at martialartsbelmont.com.
Excellent. Bob and Bobby Moran, thank you very much for coming on this morning. We appreciate it, and let's get you some people down there. How's that?
All right, sounds good to us.
Great.
I'm ready for the workout. Keith, you want to go?
I am. I'm up for my comeback. I'm ready to go.
All right, thank you again,
guys. For guys my age, I'm 58, and I tell you, martial arts, I feel like I'm 35 at the most, you know?
Oh, that's a good feeling.
I've been doing martial arts every day, and I still feel like a young guy. I really do.
I've seen the pictures. You look good, man. You look really fit.
I suggest everyone that's my age or older, come in and do karate. You're never too old for it.
Awesome.
Definitely never too old for it.
There you go,
it's
folks.
It's going to help you. It's going to help you with a lot of things in life, not just getting in shape. It's going to help you mentally, too.
Yep. Mind and body, absolutely.
Thank you, Bob and Bobby. You guys take care. Have a great Sunday.
Thanks, guys.
Bye-bye.
Yeah,
take care.
Thank you. You guys, too.
Bye-bye. All right. So that's what people should be doing today. Get back in shape before the football games
start. Let's get active. Bushido in Belmont, Mass.
Yeah. Bob and Bobby Moran. I like that driveway thing.
Yeah, driveway. You do it in your house. Fantastic.
Yeah, right.
Either or.
Hey, Keith, I know your favorite pizza